we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon and we took a little beans, and we caught the bloody British in a town in New Orleans. We fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began to run it on down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. We looked down the river and we see the British come, and there must have been 100 of them beating on the drum. They stepped so high and they made the bugles ring. We stood beside our cotton fields and didn't say a thing. We fired our guns and the British kept a-coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began to run it on down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Old Hickory Creek said we could take them by surprise if we didn't fire a musket till we looked them in the eye. We held our fire till we see their faces well, then we opened up our squirrel guns and really gave them well. We fired our guns and the British kept coming. There wasn't as many as there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began to run it on down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Yeah, they ran through the briars and they ran through the brambles and they ran through the bushes where a rabbit couldn't go. They ran so fast that the hounds couldn't catch them on down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. We fired our cannon till the barrel melted down, so we grabbed an alligator and we fought another round. We filled his head with cannonballs and powdered his behind, and when we touched the powder off, the gator lost his mind.
The news had come out in the First World War. The bloody Red Baron was flying once more. The Allied command ignored all of its men and called on Snoopy to do it again. Was the night before Christmas, 40 below, when Snoopy went up in search of his bow. Despite Red Baron, fiercely they fought. With ice on his wings, Snoopy knew he was caught.
Christmas bells, those Christmas bells, rang up from the land, asking peace of all the world, and the thrill to man.
The Baron had Snoopy dead in his sights. He reached for the trigger to pull it up tight. Why he didn't shoot, well, we'll never know. Or was it the bells from the village below?
He came!
Christmas bells, those Christmas bells, ringing through the land, bringing peace to all the world and goodwill to man.
The Baron made Snoopy fly to the Rhine and forced him to land behind the enemy lines. Snoopy was certain that this was the end when the Baron cried out,
Merry Christmas, my friend!
The Baron then offered a holiday toast, and Snoopy, our hero, saluted his host. And then with a roar, they were both on their way, each knowing they'd meet on some other day.
Christmas bells, those Christmas bells, ringing through the land, bringing peace to all the world and goodwill to man.
Hey!
doctors in.
In May of 1941, the war had just begun. The Germans had the biggest ship that had the biggest guns. The Bismarck was the fastest ship that ever sailed the sea. On her decks were guns as big as steers and shells as big as trees. Out of the cold and foggy night came the British ship, the Hood. And every British seaman, he knew and understood. They had to sink the Bismarck, the terror of the sea. Stop those guns as big as steers and those shells as big as trees. To find that German battleship that's making such a fuss, we gotta sink the Bismarck, cause the world depends on us.
Hit the decks a running, boys, and spin those guns around.
When we find the Bismarck, we gotta cut her down. The Hood found the Bismarck, and on that fatal day, the Bismarck started firing 15 miles away. We gotta sink the Bismarck, was the battle sound. But when the smoke had cleared away, the mighty Hood went down. For 6 long days and
Ace, you look so cool!
Build a snowman or ride our bike around the halls. I think some company's overdue. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls. Hang in there, Joan. It gets a little lonely, all these empty rooms.